Hi again, everybody. This is Rob Jolliffe, President of Sabre Limited. I'm going to do a quick kind of presentation of a migration of Dynamics 365 on-premise to cloud. And we're going to be using Business Central on both sides, Business Central 14 in the on-prem version and Business Central 16.2, which is the newest version as of mid-June 2020. And a little bit about Sabre. Sabre is a Dynamics 365 Business Central training, implementation, and consulting specialist for small and medium manufacturing companies throughout North America. We specialize particularly in engineered order and print manufacturing. So today what we're going to be doing, we're going to have a Business Central 14.6, that is a Business Central 14 CU6 environment that's installed on a test system that I have. We're going to install the integration runtime. We're going to connect to a BC 16.2 environment in the cloud that I set up as a basically a demonstration system. We're going to enter all the connection data that's needed and we're going to let it run. And this is the first time I've done this through, so this is an experiment and a learning experience for everybody. I found this blog on in-tech systems, which is a pretty good step-by-step of how to execute the process. And I'm running a virtual box that has Windows 10 on it and has Business Central 14 installed. So we're going to start by, if we review the blog, the step-by-step instructions are to begin with assisted setup. So we could do the assisted setup from our Business Central 14 environment for setting up the intelligent cloud. And when we do go into that and we accept the warning and hit next, it's going to launch into our Business Central Online site, which I have logged into already. And so it's immediately going to bring me to Business Central Online. Now, I want to do this in the sandbox. And so I'm going to search for the sandbox. And I am going to connect to it. And so I'll open the sandbox. Now, we're going to basically what we're going to do, and this is the correct account. So I'm going to use this account. So I've set up a Dynamics 365 Business Central Online demo account, which is what I'm going to be using for this process. We'll close this one down. No, I'll leave that site. That's fine. So here I am, and now we're going to do the assisted setup again. This time we're going to do it online. And we're going to do the Cloud Insights. Cloud Migration, it's called in this version. And we'll accept it. We're basically following the same process, so we could start it from either, but I am going to choose a Business Central previous version. Now, and by the way, if we look at this, we can do Business Central, which would, I presume, be 16, Business Central previous version, 14s and 15s, and Dynamics Great Plains. So we're going forward with Business Central previous version. It's going to set up a SQL configuration, and then we need a SQL configuration string. So I happen to have created a SQL configuration string. It looks like this: server equals, and then the server name, database equals, and the database name, user ID equals, and I had to create a SQL database user ID, it does not work with your Windows, and then a password, which I set to this complicated password of this is the password. And then integration runtime. So if you haven't installed the integration runtime, you next out of this, leave it blank. So once we're into this page, we need two things from here. We need this authentication key. I double click on it, right click and copy. I'm going to need that for the integration runtime. And we go to the download page where we're going to download the integration runtime from. So we'll click download, and I'm just going to take the newest one. I've already downloaded it. So I'm going to X out of this, and I'm going to go to my downloads folder. So I have the integration runtime here. This is the newer one. I downloaded both. And we'll do this installation. We're going to accept the terms. We're going to install it in the default location. And we're going to install. Now, before we do our migration, any extensions that we have that we want to migrate the data from the on-prem to the cloud, we need to have those extensions installed in the cloud. And we generally are going to want the same extensions on both sides. So if we have created our custom extensions with our 50,000 range objects, then we're going to deploy those extensions into our cloud environment. So our integration runtime is almost done. Now, what the integration runtime is doing is it's sitting on the computer, usually the one with the SQL Server on it, which this is a single installation on a Windows 10 environment, so it's going to work fine. But that integration runtime is going to be connecting up to an Azure data source. It's basically registering this computer with Azure SQL so that we can transfer files or transfer database contents back and forth. Good. So we're finished. It's going to launch the integration manager setup. And what it wants is it wants that authentication key that we had from here that we copied. And it wants to put that in the integration manager runtime. So we'll put that in. That's what connects your integration manager up into the cloud. So we register it and it'll verify the authentication key. Now, at this point in time, we may need that integration code to put back into Business Central. We're going to see. Okay, so our integration manager is being registered successfully. We can close it now. It's running on our computer. We go next. All right. So now what's happened is that our Business Central on-prem is essentially connected to the cloud. And there were five companies that were configured in that environment. So I can either select them or migrate them all. This is going to wipe out the data in my sandbox. I am in Kronos Canada or Kronos USA, I believe. So I'm going to skip USA. And I can migrate this immediately, or I could schedule it to happen at a particular time. I'm just going to do it immediately. There's not that much data. And so that's it. That should now begin replicating my my cloud data from my on-prem into my cloud environment. So my on-prem data should be being read from the server now and loaded up into the cloud. So we followed the instructions in this blog. If we go back a little while later and we look for the intelligent cloud migration, the cloud migration management, then what we can see is we could see a scheduled normal Dynamics 360 cloud migration setup is completed. So the migration setup's completed. Let's run the migration now. Oh, it's still creating companies in the background. So if we go in and we take a look at our settings, we have just Kronos USA and my company. So in the background now, it's creating, let's refresh the status. So it has not successfully transmitted any tables. 999 more table or more tables to be migrated. So we'll have to wait a little while. All right, it's been about an hour. So let's go see what we've got. All right, so this is my sandbox environment. And when I first started, there was no Kronos Canada. There is now Kronos Canada Inc. I have actually got a group of companies that have been set up. And so I have a variety of different companies here that have been created, Mexico, Canada, and these other ones. So what I'm going to do, let's go take a look at production orders, because one of the reasons I did this is because the out-of-the-box demo environments do not contain any production manufacturing information. But if we go to, let's go to items, and we should have our bicycle if this migrated completely. There's our bicycle, which by default doesn't come in the standard package. And if we go into the bike, we should be able to go take a look at under navigation, under bill of materials. If we look at cost shares, we should see a structure for bicycle with a tree showing all of the different cost shares. Voila. That's what we've got now. So we have the entire structure of the bicycle with all of the materials and production information in it. So let's actually go see if there's any production orders in the system. There should be a few firm planned production orders. And there's two. Two firm plan production orders, one for the bike, one for the touring bike. Let's see if there's any released production orders. Usually there's a few of these in the sample data as well. And there we go, six released production orders. So we have successfully migrated the on-prem data from our Business Central environment to the cloud in about an hour. Now that was the Kronos databases that are standard in a Microsoft Dynamics environment. The only one that I didn't migrate was Kronos USA, because in my my attempt to implement it, the Kronos USA was the one I was logged into. So I would have to create another company just to be a placeholder so I could log into the other company and then run the migration script. And you'll notice that I have a 98% success of table migration. I believe because I have a couple of extensions installed, I have a few tables that didn't migrate. So if I look at the tables with warnings, I think these are tables that there is no extension. Table does not exist in the local instance. So these are tables that couldn't be installed. And if I look at these tables not migrated, I think these are mostly also extension tables that didn't migrate, and some user group and user data, which I wouldn't expect. So some of it did not migrate and some of it did. Configuration templates and data migration data and some great plane stuff that I'm not familiar with. But none of this looks like standard tables that contain important data that we usually need to have migrated. So it really does look like this migration for the most part worked successfully. And certainly the number of successful table migrations was quite large. So very exciting. And that pretty much is a demonstration of the data migration. Thank you.